So let's say we have the following. We have y double prime plus y is equal to this piecewise function. It's going to be t when t is between 0 and 1. And it's going to be 0 when t is greater than or equal to 1. The conditions here, y of 0 is 0, and y prime is 0. First thing you want to do is you want to deal with this side. Make it one line using the unit step function. So I'm going to rewrite the differential equation like this. You want it to start out being t, so we're going to have t, right? Then you want it to go away, so you want to subtract t. You want that to happen when t is equal to 1, so you're going to multiply by u of t minus 1, okay? And the idea here is that this function here is going to be 0 or 1. Before 1, this whole thing is 0, which means this is not there. I just have t. When t hits 1, this thing turns to 1. I get t minus t, which gives me 0, right? So this is why we're doing the unit step function. We can write this now as one line, which gets us closer to taking a Laplace transform. Now, we still cannot take a Laplace transform because this does not match this. This one you don't have to worry about. This is not a multiply, right? It's not attached to u. This one you have to match the argument. So this is an easy enough one to do. You have y double prime plus y is t minus. And I'm going to add a step. You probably skip the step, but I want t minus 1, and I'm going to have to add 1, right? Like that. And that ends the end of the die. Let me switch to another one. So I'll change color. For any reason, I'm going to write below on that one. So you're going to have t minus 1. Maybe I'm going to add all the steps here. I probably skip some of these, but I want to make sure it looks clear on what I'm doing here. Now we can take a Laplace transform on both sides. So if we take Laplace transform, we're going to have s squared y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus capital Y of s, right? On the right-hand side, we're going to have 1 over s squared minus 1 over s squared e to the negative s minus 1 over s e to the negative s. So that gets us the Laplace transform that we need, right? So we've taken this piecewise function, we've learned it as one line, we altered it, so now we can take a Laplace transform, right? And you don't have to go back and use the definition of the integral, so it's a lot simpler. So from this point, let's go ahead and solve for y of s. So we don't need to, we kind of search for capital Y of s's. And so I have two of them there. I can factor out an s squared plus 1, and I have a capital Y of s. From there, I would plug in my conditions, right, and move it over to the other side. But the conditions are both zero, so I don't actually have to worry about it here, so I just end up with this. 1 over s squared minus 1 over s squared e to the negative s minus 1 over s e to the negative s. Okay. Solve for y of s by dividing. And so we have 1 over s squared times s squared plus 1 minus 1 over s squared times s squared plus 1 e to the negative s minus 1 over s times s squared plus 1 e to the negative s. And again, you see how easy that was to solve, right? Once we take the transformation, the algebra is very, very simple. And of course, now we have to go back to our original world and solve for the differential equation. So to go backwards, we're going to do the same thing we've done before. We're going to have to use partial fractions, right? Or you know, you can make it work like we've done before. Try to avoid that. We should be able to do that here pretty easily. So let's see. Let me move over. I need a little bit more room here. So y of s. So this can be broken apart easily, right? This is s squared. This is s squared plus 1. It's going to have to be 1 and 1. This is going to have to be negative, right? S squared plus 1 minus s squared gives me 1. What's nice about this is the same thing, right? I need a parenthesis here, but it's going to be 1 over s squared minus 1 over s squared plus 1, right? Or plus or minus, if you'd rather, right? Times e to the negative s. But again, this part here is the same thing as that, so that's an easy one to do. Okay, now this one. Well, you could argue, well, I got to do partial fractions, right? Because they don't match up. Well, again, this is where you want to be. Yeah, it's actually pretty easy that they didn't match up. I can make this an s squared, right? Now, you have to have a 1, so you would pull the s out, right? So what I would do is this. I would write this as minus s, right? And then this part is what we just did again, right? So I would put this in here as 1 over s squared plus a negative 1 over s squared plus 1 e to the negative s. I hope that makes sense. These are things you want to do if you can do it. It makes your life so much easier. Now, the s, of course, has to go back in again. I pulled it out so I could do this, but the s has to go back in again. Also on one page, I should be able to pull this off, and I'm right today. I have 1 over s squared minus 1 over s squared plus 1 minus 1 over s squared minus 1 over s squared plus 1 e to the negative s minus, now, if I bring this s back in, you're going to have 1 over s and then minus s over s squared plus 1 e to the negative s, okay? Again, you notice how I avoided doing partial fractions, which we want to do when we can, because it's a huge time sink. At this point, now we can take the inverse Laplace transform. So here's what we get. This one, of course, is just t. That's sine of t, right? Okay. Now I'm going to do this a little bit differently here. So I'm going to have a minus. I'm going to put all of these together, because it's pretty easy to do. Probably more than any, but I'll make sure I have enough. Because you notice we have with the remaining, they all have this, right? So I know they're all going to have u of t minus 1 when we go back. So I'm going to take care of that right away. Then I'm just going to focus on these, right? So 1 over s squared become t. But again, because of that, you have to have t minus 1. Minus, that would be sine of t, but again, because of that, it's sine of t minus 1. Okay, this would be 1. This would be 1. I've already pulled the negative out here, right? Don't worry about that negative here. T minus 1 is 0, that's still 1. And that becomes cosine, right? So minus cosine of t, but t becomes t minus 1. Okay. Hopefully that makes sense. But what you would actually do, and you don't have to go this far, realize that your original differential equation was piecewise, right? Between 0 and 1, you had something bigger than 1, you had something else, right? I'm going to do the same thing here. This is actually a piecewise function. Before 1, this whole thing is turned off. You actually just have t minus sine t. That's your answer when t is between 0 and 1, right? Now, when it's 1, this whole thing turns on. So what you actually have is this. You have t minus sine t minus t plus 1 distributing out plus sine of t minus 1 minus 1 plus cosine of t minus 1. This occurs when t is greater than or equal to 1. And that would be your solution, right? You simplify it a bit, of course, right? You know, these would drop out, and I'll let you do that. I'm asking you that anyway, but that's really what you get. So when you solve this differential equation here, you're actually solving two of them. You're solving that differential equation, right? And that's my answer on that interval. Then you're solving that differential equation, and this is your answer on that interval.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.